go. I figured it out. Hey, Pearl. Hey, Devin.
What's up, everybody?
Sorry, I'm a little bit late. I was trying to figure out how to pen a comment, and before I knew it, it's like, oh, it's 2 o'clock. You have to get on right now. So, but I'm glad it worked. I figured it out. We're here. We're doing it. Let's go, shall we? Welcome, everybody, to Above the Belt. So it's also in celebration of Flex Friday. So what you're gonna see is everything from the hips up is gonna get a little bit of love and attention. We're gonna need a couple different things to be successful in today's class. I have 2 different sets of dumbbells. If you do not have 2 different sets, I totally get it. Find something that works best for you. You feel free to modify wherever is going to be needed. So there's that. You're also gonna make sure you have yourself a pair of mini bands. Now again, if you don't have a pair, you only have 1 set, totally fine. Do the very best you possibly can. Because we are focusing primarily on the upper body, I want you to remember that your shoulders, wrists, elbows, all those things are gonna be used multiple times ad nauseum in today's workout. So if you're dealing with any sort of limitations or barriers, please listen to your body. Make modifications or changes that you think are gonna be necessary for you, because at the end of all this, I want you all to feel very, very successful, all right? So here's a little bit of like how the class is gonna lay out. If you were took with me on Wednesday for a below the belt, then you'll know that it's pretty much the same format. We're gonna have 1 minute of 1 strength exercise. We have about 15 seconds to transition to your 30-second burner. So the 30-second burner should be the contrasting muscle group. So we're working in front of the body, then we're gonna do something for the back of the body. So by the time we're done, you should feel very, very balanced by the time we're finished, all right? Now we have 6 different blocks to get through. It's gonna take us about 30 minutes in total length. Hopefully you guys are ready. I'm ready to go. So without further ado, let's position ourselves into the ready position, shall we? Walk your feet so they're a little bit wider than shoulder distance apart and turn so you're facing towards me. So you're facing towards the front of the room. All right, I'm gonna walk my feet wide. I'm gonna create 2 fists off to the side. Let's create a little mobility. You're gonna start to roll the wrists in 1 direction. They're going to reverse that direction. Now give me some shoulder rolls. Roll the shoulders forward 4 times. Now roll them back 4 times. Take the right arm, give me big arm circles to the front. Now start to take them back. Do the same thing on the other side. Roll it forward. Now roll them back. Hands on your shoulders, roll the elbows forward 4 times. Now roll them back. Take the arms out to the side, give some chest openers. We open and close the arms, squeezing shoulder blades together. You have 4 more. 3, 2, torso rotations. We're gonna go side to side. You're gonna take your hips and your heels along for the ride as you start to twist. Add a reach across your heart. As if you're trying to touch the sides of the room with your open palm, like a nice little high five. Over 4 more, 3 more, 2 more, hold center, arms cross. Take big circles in 1 direction, reverse that direction. Kind of opening up the T-spine, do that again, 1 direction. Then roll it back. Okay, flexion extension, hands on top of the hips. You flex forward, roll it back, forward, and back. So we're getting some mobility here. 4 more. 3 more. 2 more. Last one. Take a big inhale. Reach your hands above your head right here. Reach it up. Exhale, forward fold. Reach down. Do that again. Reach it up. Exhale, forward fold. 2 more times. Hands all the way up. Exhale, drop it down low. 1 last time. Hands all the way up. Exhale, drop it low. Now take those hands right back up high. Looking to toss them down, reach them up. Toss them down, reach them up. And we're gonna do that just a total of 4 more times, guys. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, shake out the wrists. 1 more time, crisscross the arms. All right, everybody, let's kind of warm up the core as well as the upper body. We're gonna start our first exercise, which is gonna lead us into the first block. So sort of a primer before we actually get to the first block. What I need everybody to do, go ahead and find yourself into a push-up plank position. Place your hands down to the floor, walk your feet wide, palms are open. Draw the shoulders in towards your belly button, or pull your shoulders down your back, belly button in towards your spine. Now you're gonna hang out here for about 30 seconds as we begin to explain exercise number one. Exercise one, we're gonna need our two heavy dumbbells. The dumbbells will be into your hands. You should still be in plank. You're going to give yourself a big shoulder press at the very, very top. I'm looking for narrow grip here, my friends. So go ahead and grab onto your dumbbells, find your feet. Okay, feet about hip distance apart. Roll the shoulders down and back. Bring the dumbbells so that they lift at your shoulders. Now press the bells above your head, press them up. Then slowly bring them all the way back down. Now as you press, I want you to think you're looking to reach your, the dumbbells to the ceiling, but draw your shoulders down your back. Exhale, push, and bring it down. Now your 1 minute begins right here. We have 1 minute to perfect this motion. What you're gonna notice is the work should be located towards the front end of the shoulder. And as it comes all the way to the very, very top, your shoulders should come down, but the bells go up above their head. So it's almost like an elevator pulley. Now I want you to think active pull down as the bells start to come down close to the torso, almost like you're sitting in a narrow hallway. Big press up, bring it right back down. About 30 seconds more here, guys. Shoulders should start to get nice and warm. Big press, bring it back down. Now I'm looking for solid, continuous motion here. I don't necessarily need for you to bang out, because the bang out's gonna come out very, very soon with our secondary exercise, which will be here in a little bit less than 15 seconds. As the bells go up, I want you to try to maintain a little bit of space between each one of the bells. It helps keep tension on top of the shoulders. 3, 2, and 1. Dumbbells go down. Grab onto your mini band. Now the band to your round the wrist. Open up the palms and squeeze your shoulder blades together. Create two fists. Now you're simply gonna bend the elbows, reach elbows up high, then right back low. Here we go, guys. 30 seconds. This time I want you to think speed. Drive the elbows up high to the ceiling. Hold the belly button in towards your spine. As the band comes up, can you position it just below the chin? We're hitting a different section of the shoulder here. It's called your medial belt, the side of your shoulder. Helps create a beautiful round. Gorgeous shoulders. 3, 2, and 1. Recover. There's that band. Okay, shake it out. So we have about 20 seconds where we go into round two. We're gonna hit the same muscle group, but just in a different way. We're gonna go into wide shoulder press this time. So last time we were narrow, this time we were wide. I'm looking for you to squeeze your shoulder blades as you lift the bells above your head. Go ahead and grab onto the bells. Drive the belly button in towards your spine. Elbows are slightly flared. 3, 2, here we go. Press, slowly bring them back down. Do that again. Now something that helps me is I literally exhale as the bells go up high. So that way I can maintain integrity at my core. Now notice, as the bells come down, elbows are gonna go close to the torso. And I want you to think that as the bells come down, you're almost trying to separate them, right? Squeezing shoulder blades together. So it's an active motion on the way down, as well as an active motion on the way up, but still maintaining that space between the shoulders and the earlobes. Bring it down. So when we have these 1 minutes of work, I want you to try to bend time, right? You're gonna take as much time as you possibly can, knowing that when we come into the secondary motion, we're looking for speed. 3, 2, 1, and recover. Lose it, grab onto your band. Now I'm gonna place my band. This time so it goes back above my head. I have lat pull downs. I create two fists. I'm gonna bend the elbows, take the band so it goes behind the neck. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Pull, reach. So this is an active motion for the sides of the torso, getting those lats. So if you're a person who likes to do pull-ups, or if you'd like to do muscle ups, this is the exercise you should be doing almost every single time you hit your back. It's a nice little primer. Pull, reach, pull, reach. Just a few more, 3, 2, and 1. Recover.
Are you gonna go like that?
No?
Wanna stay up?
Okay, this is Bella, if you guys can see her. She's gonna be our workout partner for the day, or maybe not, I don't know. Anyway, we're moving on to block number 2. So we're done with our shoulder work in that particular fashion. We're gonna move on to block 2. So our block second 2 is gonna be all about the wide row. Grab onto your 2 heavy dumbbells. You're gonna hinge forward, elbows in line with the shoulders. Ready, set, go. Here we go. Squeeze shoulder blades together. Reach it back down towards the floor. Now as the bells come up high, I want you to think, yes, that beautiful squeeze, opening it up so that the elbow is in line with the wrist and wrist is in line with the shoulders as it comes up. Separating those 2 dumbbells, creating space in between. When we come into your secondary exercise, we're gonna be hitting in the reverse direction. The reverse direction, you guessed it, is going to be your wide push-up. So you're looking to bring the heart in between the 2 dumbbells as you come into your push. Now in that push, you have a couple different options. You can stay in a full plank, or you can take it down to knees, whatever makes the most sense for you. Either way, you have 3, 2, 1, and recover. Okay, bells down, walk the feet back and the hands wide. We have 30 seconds, as many push-ups as you possibly can. Hands are gonna go just outside the mat. 3, 2, 1, here we go. As many push-ups as you can, down and up. So during these 30 second bursts, I want you to really kind of test yourself. Can you reach all the way to failure? See, I've reached so many. I gotta come down to knees. We still have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, recover. Okay, second section of our back. In the first round, we did wide. This round, we're gonna go narrow. So I want you to think, elbows are gonna be super close to the torso. You're gonna reach down, drive the elbows up high to the ceiling, lather, rinse, and repeat. Our target zone, center of your back. All right, grab onto your bells, hinge it forward, 3, 2, let's go. Drive the bells up, opening up the bells at the very bottom and at the very top, creating that space. I'm actually went too fast, so I'm gonna slow it down just a touch here. Ultimately, the goal here is to hit the center of your back. Good news, guys, you have about 30 seconds left. Now, if you notice, I started to stagger my feet slightly just so I can make sure that I'm protecting my low back. If you begin to feel it into your lower spine, you can join me into this staggered position, or you can lift your heart a little bit higher. But ultimately, we're looking for the heart to be as close to parallel to the floor as possible. 3, 2, 1, and recover. Bells down. Okay, second set of push-ups. This time we're gonna keep it narrow. Tricep push-ups, so the opposite direction that we did the first time. Walking down to the floor. Knees or full plank, your choice. 3, 2, go. 30 seconds. We're looking for that beautiful pump. Find the arms and the chest. Now if you thought we'd be done with chest after this, you're severely mistaken, my friends. We're gonna be hitting it again, just in a different way. Less than 10 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Wow. All right. So, got a mini pump in already. Hopefully you guys are starting to feel it. Blood flow coming from hips up, above the belt. Here we go in 2, Block number three. Block three. We're gonna need the lighter bells if you have them. If you do not, you can grab onto a heavier bell and not do as many reps. We have scoops, guys. Small bend in the elbows. You're gonna scoop it forward. Here we go. 1 minute. Bend the elbows, scoop it forward. Shh. So I want you to notice, as the bells come up, I squeeze them into the center as if I'm trying to squeeze in between my two chest plates. That's exactly where you want to be at. Squeezing it here. There's a gentle bend in the elbows. Up we go. Now this exercise is all about front of the shoulders and under part of your chest. So if you're a person who would like to have a more lifted chest, this is the exercise for you. Instant boob lift without even having to go to the doctor. 10 seconds, guys. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover. Bells come down. Check it out. Grab onto your band, bow and arrow. One arm extended, the other arm, pull straight back. Arm extended, we pull back. 3, 2, go. As many repetitions as you possibly can. I have one stiff arm, the other arm, pull straight back, wrapping around the shoulder blade. Push and pull, push and pull. I'm pushing with my straight arm, I'm pulling with my back arm. Hitting back part of my shoulder, getting those delts the opposite direction of that scoop. 4, 3, 2, 1, recover. Take it out, roll it back. Woo. All right, guys, same series, over to the other side, slightly different. I need you to either pick up your heavy or your lighter bell, whichever one you have. You're gonna grab onto the bell, underhand a little bit like this. Palms are open. We're gonna do what's called a spin press. Squeezing shoulder blades together. You're going to extend your arms forward and pull them right back in. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Squeezing, bring it right back in. Push it forward, shoulders down. Pull it right back in. Forward it goes. Bring it right back in. So I almost like to think like I'm serving a plate in front. Big push, pulling right back in. Now the hardest thing is, the slower you go, the more challenging it becomes. 30 seconds. You guys, this is way more challenging than what you think. Woo. Here we go. Push, pull it back. Pull it back. We have less than 10 seconds. Get those last few repetitions in. 4, 3, 2, 1, recover. Now whatever arm you did last time, do the opposite arm last time. I have my left arm extended. This time I'm gonna do my right arm. I extend the arm, I'm gonna pull it back. 3, 2, go. Pull, reach, pull, reach. 30 seconds here, guys. I want you to imagine you're literally holding a bow. You're pulling back the string for the arrow. Notice as you pull back, you're engaging upper part of your back, rear delt. So, it's the opposite of that push that we had from before. All right, kids, less than 10 seconds. See if you can pick up the tapes. 4, 3, 2, 1. Recover, shake it out. All right, we are halfway through, guys. 3 blocks down, we have 3 more remaining. Woo! All right, we're gonna make our way down to the floor. We have narrow chest press next. Gonna flip over the hip. Bells will go next to my mat. I'm gonna roll it back. Narrow chest press. We're gonna keep it in super tight. Looks just like this. Press it up high to the ceiling. 3, 2, 1, up we go. Big push, squeeze each other together. Slowly bring them right back down. Squeeze, and then bring it down. Now take your time on this one. As the bells go up,
I want you to notice I'm going to keep just a little bit of space between my two bells, almost like they're two opposite end magnets, right? They're trying to come together, I'm trying to push them together, but they're going to maintain that integrity between. Valves keep more tension on top of the chest where it belongs. Push, squeeze, bring it right back down. Now, you might often hear, did you feel the squeeze? The squeeze truly does matter here. Banging out a bunch of repetitions without actually feeling the contraction does you no service, right? So you want to feel the contraction, no matter if you're on your way up or if you're on your way down. 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover. Bells go down.
We got T poses, guys. So you're gonna hold into a high plank position, drive the bell up high or right your hand up high, come back down and switch over to the other side. So this is the one time we're not using our bells, or not using our mat, our bands. Up we go, squeeze, squeeze. Now notice I'm going to bend the elbow, then reach it up high, bend, reach. So I'm coming into that full extension with a little rotation, bend and reach. Less than 10 seconds, just a few more reps. 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover. Dig it out. Woo! Roll out the wrist. All right, pump is coming in. I rolled that on a Friday, looking good. All right, let's roll back. We're back onto our back again. This time, we're gonna do chest flies. Holding onto our bell, goes above the heart. Arms will open up onto the side. In 3, 2, 1, here we go. Open up, bring it all the way back in. Now the chest fly, you wanna imagine that you're about to hug onto a beach ball. So it's just in between, just a bit like this. So notice how the elbows have a gentle bend and then they squeeze very, very tough. Open, pull, once again focusing on the breath, opening it up, squeezing it together. You have less than 20 seconds here, my friends. Take your time, really feel the contraction, gently drop the elbows down to the floor as they open up. Squeezing together as they come up to the top. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release it. Okay, one of my favorite exercises is called a hitchhiker. So you're gonna create two thumbs up. Arms will go just in front of the thighs. You're gonna hinge slightly forward. Arms go up, squeeze your legs together. So you're gonna pull them up to the ceiling. Here we go. Up, 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 up. So there should be constant tension on top of the shoulder blades, in between the shoulder blades actually, upper part of your back, behind the shoulders, getting those rear delts for maybe the fourth time today. Boom. Almost there, 10 seconds, push, push. Try to touch the thumbs to the ceiling. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well done, y'all, well done. Okay, here we go. Next block. Block 5. Let's get some biceps in there, shall we? For block 5, you're going to grab onto your two heavy dumbbells. We're going to stay in the kneeling position for this one. Elbows are going to stay close to the torso. We're going to take both arms together. You're going to bend the elbows so that they come the dumbbells come closer to the shoulders. Then you're going to reach them all the way back down. Again, we have a minute of work, so I want you to take your time here. 3, 2, 1. Take your time. Slowly bring it down. Do that again. Lift and squeeze, bring it back down low, and again, squeeze, bring it low. Now you might be asking, why are we in the stay in this kneeling position? Good question. When you stay in this kneeling position, you are forced to use everything from your hips up, also including your glutes. So it actually makes it a little bit more challenging because we don't have the lower body to help us out, to trick us into thinking that we can go heavier, when really our most effective when we isolate that muscle. It's tough, guys. You have 10 seconds left. If you're doing this correctly, these last 10 seconds should feel like a struggle. 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab onto your band. I'm gonna grab onto the heavier band for me, which is the green one. I'm gonna give myself a hand over the heart. The opposite hand goes inside of the band and I push it straight down. Here we go. Tricep push down, single arm. So we're hitting the counter of my front, which is my bicep. We're gonna hit those triceps, squeezing. I'm gonna keep it single arm on this one so that way I can focus strictly on this arm. 15 seconds. 10 seconds left. Let's finish what we started. We are good in 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover. Whew. All right. Zomen's curls, also known as Z curls. That's what's up next. In our Z curls, you grab onto the bell so that they face forward. You bring them all the way up to your shoulders, reverse it, arms come all the way back down, turn the palms so they face back forward. So we have 1 minute of work on this one, guys. If it becomes so challenging that you cannot do it the whole full minute, go into alternating. Ready, set, here we go. Curl, flip, bring it down, flip, up, right back down low. Now remember, your core should be helping you out here. Boom. Keeping you as solid as you possibly can. Now, I don't know about you, my arms are feeling this one for less than 30 seconds. Up it goes, keeping it tight. 20 seconds. Plenty of opportunity here, my friends. 15 seconds. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it. All right. So, last time, I extended this arm. This time, I'm going to switch over to the other side. Give myself a nice little hand on top. I push it down. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Push. Bring it down. Push. Bring it down. Elbow stays close to the torso. Big exhale. As you push down. I'm going to start to pick up my tempo here just a touch. Looking good, guys. You have 9 more seconds left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover. Yikes. Okay. Guess what, my friends? We've made it to the final block. Last one. Let's finish what we started, shall we? Now, in this last block, we will be hitting skull crushers. Back of the arms. And then, we're going to go right to, actually, wait. Yeah, skull crushers, and then we're going to do narrow curls. This is going to be a little bit different. Alright, grab onto those belts.
Elbows on the head, elbows forward, bend the elbows. Here we go. Big exhale, press the belts up high. Now, skull crusher. It just simply means you're actually not really pushing the skull here. You're simply bringing the dumbbells so they come close to the temple of the head. Elbows should be up high or facing forward. So you want to think almost like there's a beautiful hinge or lever, right? In between where your elbow joint is, you simply bend in the elbow, then you press and drive it up high to the ceiling. Once again, we're hitting these triceps. This is maybe our 4th time hitting our triceps in today's workout, so you should feel a beautiful pump by the time you're done. I like to call these the t-shirt exercise. They help you look great in any t-shirt. You have less than 10 seconds remaining on the clock. We're gonna hit the front of the body, get those biceps for another set. In 4, 3, 2, and 1.
All right, so knees are bent. You need just one of your dumbbells on this one. We're looking for rapid fire curls. So elbows are gonna be close, pull and extend. 3, 2,
One, rapid fire. Down and up, down and up. It's our last little speed burst of work. Come on, y'all. Almost there. As many as you can. Pump it out. 15 seconds. We are going to cross over that recovery finish line in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover. Woo! Last exercise, guys. This is it. The final exercise in our series. After this, we're all done. We have core. Why? What any sort of upper body exercise would be done without incorporating our core? Now, in this core work, what you're going to see, we're going to go what's called torch sit-ups. So, legs are extended. Bell will be positioned over top of the heart. You're going to roll all the way back, and you're going to roll all the way back up. 3, 2, here we go. Roll it back. Roll it all the way back up. Do that again. Down we go. All the way we go. Now we have 1 minute of work on this one. So feel free to take your time. All the way down and all the way back up. 20 seconds down. Now after all that shoulder work and all that work on the shoulders and chest, even on our triceps, this particular work should feel even more challenging because our upper body is nice and fatigued, but that adds into the challenge. Through challenge comes our change, right? We gotta be ready and willing to welcome that change. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Recover. Final exercise in our series, then we are done. All right, roll onto your front. You have basic Supermans. Hands are gonna go behind the head. Target the lower part of your spine. We pulse it up, lift. Pulse for 30 seconds, guys. Lift and lower, up and down. Nose is angled down towards the floor. Breathe it out, lift, lift. You have 17 seconds remaining. Finish what you started, y'all. Finish what you started. We're almost there. We're almost home. Last 10 seconds. We are coming across that finish line, and we are good in 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover. Oh, my gosh. Well done, everybody. Sit yourselves back. Coming into child's formation. Slowly begin to roll into hands and knees. Take a big inhale, round the back, tuck the tail. Exhale, reverse that, shoulders down. Inhale, round the back. Exhale, take it long. Slowly roll all the way up. Okay, stay kneeling, one arm out to one side of the hand, give it a small tilt. Releasing tension from the neck. Look straight down towards the floor. Look up high to the ceiling. And then switch it up, same thing onto the other side, arm comes off. Small tilt in the head. Tilt straight down. Look up. And then release it, interlace fingers behind the back, squeeze palms together, open it up. Begin to roll the neck. Reverse your direction. Roll one more time. Final time, reverse. And release it there. Take the arms, crisscross them over top. Hopefully you guys got a nice little pump there. It's like 30 minutes, but it's nice and effective. We literally hit every single muscle group. Big arm circle to the front, above our belt. Reverse it, take it back. And of course, if you'd like to go for a longer session, feel free to either replay this one, or there's a couple other exercises and other workouts I have located on my page. So I want you to feel free to work out with me anytime you guys like. Thank you so much for coming in. I will see you next time, and be very good to yourselves and to each other. Bye.